Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Hope that you are well. I'm going to start taking lecture 8 on chapter 2, Business Environment of Business Organization and Management First Paper. Dear students, in the last class, I took a class on this chapter. Topic was macro environment. Today's topics are elements of internal and external environment and business environment of Bangladesh. Dear students, in the last class, we have learned about business environment, that the environment in which the business organizations of a country are formed and operated is called business environment. Okay. The environment, the elements of business environment influence a business directly or indirectly, right? So the elements can be internal, external, natural, and unnatural. So these types of elements will influence the business directly or indirectly, positively or negatively, right? Already we have learned about the macro environment or business environment. Today we will learn about the microenvironment, the environment which will influence or impact on an organization. That elements are called microenvironment. Here is written, it refers to the business environment of a particular business organizations. Whenever we will talk about a business environment, business organization's environment, then it is called microenvironment. Okay. So microenvironment has been divided into two types. The types are internal elements and external elements. You are looking that the elements of internal environment. The elements are owner or shareholder, board of directors, workers, organization's own culture, then internal facilities of the organization, then financial condition of the business. These are the elements of internal environment of an organization, right? So these elements influence the organizations directly. Just think about owner or shareholder always think, try to get the try to achieve the target of the business. For that, it can be seen that for taking different types of decisions by the owner or shareholder. So what the owners or shareholders are thinking depends on their mind. Decision of an organization should be taken. So owner or shareholder's mind decision or mind concept will influence the decision of an organization directly. Then think about board of directors, the persons who are elected to operate the business are called board of directors. So board of directors will take decisions of all kind of decisions of an organization. So any types of decisions are depending on the skill, interest, and thinking of board of directors. So board of directors are influence an organizations directly. Then think about workers. If the workers are skilled, if the workers are dedicated to the organizations, then the organizations will be benefited. If the workers are not interested, if the workers are not skilled, if the workers try to skip the time, then the business organizations will be hampered. Okay, will get lost. So what the workers are thinking, what type of workers are doing work in the organizations, taking decisions will be taken on the basis of the workers' interest, skill, etc. So workers influence the organizations directly. Okay, organizations own culture, that means organization's own culture means the organizations, the cultures, the things which are being practiced long time in an organization are called culture, right? Like long time concept, trust, ethics, rules and regulations of an organizations, the consisting these things are called organizations own culture. So any types of decisions will be taken on the basis of this types of on the all the organization's own culture. Then internal facilities of the organizations, there are many types of facilities existing. Facilities can be seen in an organizations, but organizations to organizations the facilities can be different. So the taking decision will be taken on the basis of the facilities of the organizations, just organizational structure, facilities, available of financial capacities, then method of production, internal advantages and facilities, then institutions, dignity, then these are the internal facilities. Okay, so these types of facilities will influence the taking decision of an organization directly. Then think about financial condition of the business. If the condition of an organization is good, then the organizations can take any types of decisions. If the organization's financial condition is weak, the organizations cannot take all types of decisions. So whenever the organizations take decision, have to think about financial condition of the organizations, right? So financial conditions of the business will influence the business organizations directly. Then internal elements. Okay, external elements are competitor, buyer or consumer, supplier, middleman, strategic allies, government agencies. These are the external elements. The elements are not the part of our organizations, but these elements are out of our organizations. But these types of elements influence our organizations directly. Think about competitor. When same types of organizations available in the market, the organizations are competitors to each other. So before taking decisions, while the organizations will take decision, any decision, have to think about the competitors giving facilities, competitors thinking, competitors using elements, giving opportunities and advantages to the customers, right? So competitors will try to capture the market. The competitors use modern technology, competitors use method to produce new things, right? So before taking decisions, have to think about the competitors, these types of things. Okay, if an organizations do not think about the competitors, the organizations will fall in a problem and will not fail to achieve the target of the organizations. Then think about buyer or consumer, the persons who will buy the customers for giving money or anything are called buyer or consumers. Okay, buyers or consumers. So before taking decisions, have to think about the buyer's perception, buyer's thinking, buyer's financial ability, buyer's taste, then buyer's location. Have to think about this before taking decisions. That means buyers are influencing directly on taking decision of an organization. Then think about supplier. Supplier means the person or organizations who supply money or raw materials right? So the supplier, when the money supplier persons or organizations supply money, financial utility will be created. When the raw material supplier will supply raw materials, and production will be continued. So Sometimes before taking decisions, have to think about the supplier's mind, concept and interest. Then interest, not interest, like these things will be considered before taking decisions. Okay, then middleman, if there is any persons for supplying the goods from producer to ultimate consumers, then the persons or organizations are called middleman. Okay, if the organizations will not think to supply, if the producer will not think to supply directly to the consumers, they have to take help of middleman. So what middleman, before taking decisions, have to think about the middleman's number of middlemen, interest of middleman, behavior of middleman. All the things are considered before taking decisions of middleman. Okay, so middleman will influence the organizations directly. Then strategic allies, when two or more organizations will make organizations will be will get together to achieve the organization's target, then it is called strategic allies. So before taking decisions, have to think about the strategy, friends, strategic allies, organizations, thinking, functions, management, all the things will be considered before taking decisions. Then think about government agencies. To establish an organization, need to take help from different types of government agencies like BSTI, Export Promotion Bureau, then trademark, copyright, government agencies, right? So if your organization is industry, production organizations, then have to take permission from BSTI and have to get a certificate from BSTI for producing goods. Okay, and you are bound to follow the instructions of BSTI. If your organization is export oriented organizations, then you will have to take help of EPB, that means Export Promotion Bureau, right? These types of organizations will help and will give guidelines, and these organizations will make some guidelines, and you are bound to follow the guidelines. So these types of organizations will influence your organizations directly. So from today's lecture, we have learned about the micro environment. That means there are two types of micro environment, internal environment and external environment. And we have learned how the elements influence our organizations directly. Hope that you have understood the topic, and if you have any question, you may ask me writing your question in comment box. Thank you so much. Hope that we will take another class on this chapter, solution of creative question and MCQ. Thank you.